Hello friends, my name is Mridul and today on this particular video, we are going to discuss on a topic which is known as parallel transform. This topic belongs to electrical machine and this is a very, very important topic. And in 2015, there was a question for 2 marks. So what we will do is we are going to solve and discuss this particular question. Now, before we start with that, let us have an idea of parallel transform. So generally, parallel transformer is this particular concept is applied to share the load. Suppose the load is the rating of the load is high, so to reduce the weight of each of this particular transformer, we will share the load between 2 transformers so that each of them have reduced weight. So in that way, the reliability as well as the cost decreases, as well as the size of the transformers also decreases. Initial cost may be high, but the replacement cost and reliability cost is lower. Okay, so the equivalent circuit of a parallel transformer on the secondary side, if we see, so it will be something like that. Suppose this is E1. And this is the internal impedance of the first transformer. And suppose this is the load. And this is the secondary. Okay. Now suppose I want to share this load. So what I will do, at this particular point, I'll connect one more transformer in this way. So this is a parallel connection. Now, ideally, this voltage should be same. Why? Because we supply the voltage from the same voltage bus bar. So the primary will be supplied from the same bus bar. So ideally, what happens, this voltage ratios are same for a parallel transformer such that these 2 voltages are same. Also, ideally, the phase are also same. So in that case, what we can say that these 2 points are equipotential points. So instead of drawing it in this way, we can modify this and suppose this is the impedance, internal impedance, say R1, X1 and R2, JX2. These are the impedance of the internal impedance of both the transformers, right? So this is the equivalent circuit. Now, what happens is, suppose this particular load has a rating of S and there are 2 transformers with rating S1 or maybe say S2. Now, it may happen that S1 and S2 are not equal. So, what I want is the current division should also be in such a way or the voltage rating of both the transformers are same. Now, if the power rating of both the transformers are different, but voltage rating is same, that means the current, that means the rating of power depends on current, not on voltage. That means, suppose this particular transformer 1 is having higher rating and transformer 2 is having lower rating. I'm just taking an example. For example, say this is 1000, the load requires 1000 kVA. That means both transformer 1 and transformer 2 together has to supply this 1000 kVA. Very simple. Now, it may happen that S1 is having a rating of 600 kVA and S2 is having a rating of 400 kVA. That means this is high and this is low. But then again, voltage rating of both the transformers are same. So that means if the power rating is different, that means current in transformer 1 should be more and current in transformer 2 should be less. Now, from this circuit, it is very easy for us to understand and find out how the current will be divided by current division rule. Now suppose this is current I1 and this is current I2, and I1 plus I2 is IL. Now, since my transformer, I want my transformer 1 to have more current because that is having more rating, that will happen and that will depend on the internal impedance. Now, this is something which is very important. That means my rating S1 is, that means you see this current is inversely proportional to this impedance, or I can say this current S1 is inversely proportional to the impedance of my rating, of my transformer. So I can say S1 is inversely proportional to Z1. So in that way, so we can deduce that S1 by S2 is equal to Z1 by Z2 by Z1. Okay? Very simple. Now let us go to the problem of 2015 and let us try to apply this particular concept and see whether we are able to solve the question. So I will read the question first. It says, two single phase transformers T1 and T2, each rated 500 kVA. So let me write it down. That means something, the case is that S1 is 500 kVA and S2 is also 500 kVA. So in this case, both the transformers are rated, are having the same rating value. And then they are saying, percentage impedance of T1 and T2 are 1 plus J6 and 0.8 plus J4.8. That means Z1 per unit is 1 plus J6, and Z2 per unit is 0.8 plus J 4.8. Okay? After that, they're saying to share a load of 1000 kVA. So 1000 kVA and 0.8 lagging power factor. 0.8 power factor lag. That means inductive load. The contribution of T2, that means they're asking what is S2. So this is the question. So how do we find this? Okay, how do we find this? So how do we find this? So you see, we know that the load requirement, that means, that is SL is 1000 kVA. What is P of load? P of load is 1000 into cos of 0.8. Sorry, cos of, that means 0.8 is itself the power factor. So cos of theta, that means S cos theta, that is equal to P, and cos theta is given as 0.8. So that is 800 watt, kilowatt, sorry. Okay. Similarly, Q of L, that means reactive power that is required by the load, is 1000 into sine theta. So if cos theta is 0.8, sine theta is 0.6. So this makes it 0.6, that is 600 kVAr. So I know what is the requirement of real power and reactive power by the load. Now you see, this will be supplied by S1 plus S2 will supply S of L. That means both the transformer together will supply this load. And S1 can be written as P1 plus JQ1 plus P2 plus JQ2. And this is equal to 800 plus J600. From here I can write P1 plus P2 plus JQ1 plus Q2 is equal to 800 plus J600, very simple. That means, see, P1 and P2 together will give this particular thing. So, or I can directly say, that S1 plus S2 is equal to J600. Okay, so this is one relation. I can also write it in terms of magnitude and phase, that is S1 plus S2 will be root over of 800 whole square plus 600 whole square, and angle will be tan inverse of 600 by 800. So this becomes 1000 of tan inverse 6 by 8. Now let us go to the other relation which we have already derived, that is S1 by S2 is inversely proportional to Z2 by Z1. Now Z2 by Z1 can also be written as Z2 per unit by Z1 per unit. That is, S1 by S2 is equal to, now Z1 is given in the question, that is this particular thing, and this can be written as root over, Z1 is root over 37 tan inverse of 6, and this can be written as root over of 0.8 whole square plus 4.8 whole square and tan inverse of 4.8 divided by 0.8, that is nothing but 6. Okay? So let me calculate the value of 0.8 So this becomes 4.866 tan inverse 6. So now let me remove it here. So I'm rubbing the diagram so that I can note it. So that means S1 by S2 is equal to root over 4.866 divided by root over 37, and this is tan inverse of 6 by tan inverse of 6. So this will get cancelled and it will become 0. So it is around 0.80 degree. That means I can write that S 1 is equal to S2 0.8. This is what I can write. So I will replace that particular thing here. So this makes it S2 common 1 plus 0.8. So that means S2 is equal to 1000 by 1.8. That is 555.5 kVA. So the answer is 555.5 kV, right? So this is the technique, or this is what we can use to segregate the real power of the load and reactive power of the load, and then find out what is, and then we can relate them with this particular equation, and then with this particular second relation, that is, which is relates with the internal impedance, we can solve this particular question. So hope this video will help you to get an insight of this particular parallel transformer concepts and helps you again to solve this particular question. Okay, thank you.